Delinar studied him, taking note of his burned and bloodied uniform.
I have multiple reports of you and your soldiers letting enemy fused go once you've wounded them.
Kaladin relaxed immediately.
I think we're starting to reach a kind of understanding with them, sir. The Heavenly Ones fight with honor. I let one of them go today. In turn, their leader, Leshwi, released one of my men instead of killing him.
This isn't a game, son. We're literally fighting for the existence of our people.
I know, but this can serve us. You've noticed already how they'll hold back and attack us one-on-one, so long as we play by their rules. Considering how many more Heavenly Ones there are than Windrunners, I think we want to encourage this kind of encounter. Killing them is barely an inconvenience, as they'll be reborn. But each of ours they kill requires training an entirely new Windrunner. Getting back wounded for wounded favors us.
You never did want to fight the Parshmen. Even when you first joined my army, you didn't want to be sent against the Parshendi.
I didn't like the idea of killing people who showed us honor, sir.
Does it strike you as odd to find it among them? The Almighty, honor himself, was our god. The one their god killed.
I used to think it odd. But, sir, wasn't honor their god before he was ours?
That was one of the revelations that had shaken the foundation of the Radiance, both ancient and new. Though many of the Orders had accepted the truth as an oddity and moved on, many Windrunners had not, nor had Delinar. This world had belonged to the Singers with honor as their god, until humans had arrived, bringing odium.
All of this highlights a bigger problem. This war is increasingly being fought in the skies. Navani's flying transport will only escalate the situation. We need more Honor Spren and Windrunners.
Kaladin looked to where Syl hung in the air beside him. Delinar fixed his gaze on her a moment later, so she must have decided to reveal herself to him.
I'm sorry. My relatives can be difficult.
They have to see that we're fighting for the survival of Roshar, as much as for the survival of the Alethi. We can't do that without their help.
To my cousins, you are dangerous. As dangerous as the Singers. The betrayal of the Knights Radiant killed so many of them.
The other Spren have begun coming around. They see it.
Honor Spren are more rigid. Most of them, at least.
Syl shrugged and looked to the side, as if ashamed. Human gestures from her were so common these days that Kaladin barely paused to notice them.
We need to do something. It's been 8 months without a new Honor Spren coming to us. But that's a problem I suppose I'll continue to contemplate. For now, I'm worried about the way the Heavenly Ones and the Windrunners are interacting. It smacks of neither of you giving this your all, and I can't have soldiers on the battlefield that I worry won't be able to fight when the pressure mounts.
Kaladin felt cold as he met Delinar's eyes.
So, this conversation is about me after all. What happened to me, again?
Kaladin, you're one of the best soldiers I've ever had the privilege of leading. You fight with passion and dedication. You single-handedly built up what has become the most important wing of my military, and did all of this while living through the worst nightmare I could imagine. You are an inspiration to everyone who meets you.
Thank you, sir.
Delinar nodded, then put his hand on Kaladin's shoulder.
It's time that I relieved you of duty, son. I'm sorry.
A jolt went through Kaladin, like the shock of being stabbed, or the feeling of suddenly coming awake in an unfamiliar place, frightened by a sudden noise. Every piece of you alert, looking for the fight.
No. Sir, I know how it seems.
How does it seem? Diagnose yourself, Kaladin. Tell me what you see.
Kaladin closed his eyes.
No.
Delinar gripped his shoulder tighter.
I'm no surgeon, but I can tell you what I see. A soldier who has been on the front lines for far, far too long. A man who has survived so many horrors, he now finds himself staring at nothing. His mind going numb so he doesn't have to remember. I see a soldier who can't sleep, who snaps at those who love him. He's a soldier who pretends he can still function, but he can't. He knows it.
Kaladin knocked Delinar's hand away.
You can't do this. I built the Windrunners. They're my team. You can't take that from me.
I will because I have to. Kaladin, if you were anyone else, I'd have pulled you from active duty months ago. But you're you, and I kept telling myself we needed every Windrunner.
That's true.
We need every functional Windrunner. I'm sorry. There was a point where if I'd removed you from command, it would have destroyed the momentum of the entire team. We're safely past that now. You will still be with us, but you won't be going on any more missions.
Kaladin sucked in Stormlight.
I will not be beaten down again. I will not let some light-eyed blowhard take everything from me again. I can't believe this.
Anger Spren pooled underneath him.
You were supposed to be different. You...
Why?
Why what?
Why am I different?
Because you don't throw us away! Because you care about your men.
Kaladin deflated. He suddenly felt small. A child standing before a stern parent. He wavered, putting his back to the nearest building. Syl hung beside him, looking concerned, confused. She didn't speak up to contradict Dalinar.
Why doesn't she stick up for me?
He glanced to the side. He'd brought most of what had been Bridge 4 with him. The Windrunners he'd left to protect the airship had once been Bridge 13 and their squires. So he saw a lot of friendly faces standing in the distant Narok courtyard. Rock and Teft, Renarin, Sigzil, Lynn, Lopin, Layton and Pete, Scar and Drahi, Lauren, newly forged as a full Radiant. None had yet spoken the fourth ideal. He liked to think that was as hard for them as it was for him, and none had yet cracked it.
But can they be restraining themselves because of me? Out of some misguided respect?
Kaladin turned back to Dalinar.
What if I'm not there? What if something happens when they're out fighting? What if one of them dies because I couldn't protect them?
Kaladin, what if something happens because you are with them? What if one of them dies because they expect your help, but you freeze again?
Kaladin turned aside and squeezed his eyes shut, feeling tears leak out. What if...
Storms. Dalinar's right. He's right. What are the words? You couldn't say the words. You needed to. A year ago, when Dalinar could have died, you needed to speak the words. You crumpled instead. You'll never say them, will you? You finished at the third ideal. Other Spren said that many Radiants never spoke the later oaths.
Kaladin forced his eyes open.
What do I do now?
You aren't being demoted. I want you training, teaching, and helping us fight this war. Don't be ashamed, son. You fought well. You survived things no man should have to. That sort of experience leaves scars, same as any wound. It's all right to admit to them.
Kaladin brushed fingers at his forehead and the scars he still bore.
Unhealed, despite all of my powers, years after I was branded.
Dalinar seemed uncomfortable. Perhaps upon remembering Kaladin's wound, he thought the mention of scars to be in poor taste. It wasn't. The metaphor was particularly sound.
Can I keep my oaths without fighting? I need to protect.
There are many ways to protect. Not all Radiants went into battle in the old days. I myself have found many ways to serve this war without swinging a blade on the front lines.
Kaladin looked to Syl.
Yes, you can keep your oaths this way.
You won't be the first celebrated soldier who's moved to a support position after seeing one too many friends die. God beyond willing will persuade the Honor Spren to work with us, and then we'll need to train flocks of new Windrunners. You'll be of great use overseeing Radiant training either way.
I just won't be anywhere I can cause harm, because I'm broken.
Dalinar took him by the shoulder once more, then raised his other hand, holding up a finger, as if to force Kaladin to focus on it.
This is what war does to all of us. It chews us up and spits us out, mangled. There's no dishonor in taking a step away to recover. No more than there's dishonor in giving yourself time to heal from a stab wound.
So I'll come back to the battle? I'll take a leave, then return?
If we feel it's right for you to do so, yes, that's possible.
Possible, but not likely. Dalinar has probably seen more men succumb to battle fatigue than I have. But in all my years of fighting, I've never seen someone recover. Doesn't seem the kind of thing you get over. If only I'd been stronger. Why didn't I say the words?
We'll find a way to make this a smooth, natural transition. We can introduce it to the others in whatever way you like. That said, we're also not going to delay. This isn't a request, Kaladin. It's an order. From now on, you stay out of battle.
Yes, sir.
Delinar squeezed his shoulder.
You're not valuable to me because of how many enemies you can kill. It's because you're man enough to understand and to say words like those.
He nodded, letting go.
This is not a disciplinary action, Kaladin. I'll have new orders for you tomorrow. You can trust that I will put you to work. We will explain to everyone else that it's a promotion.
Kaladin forced out a smile, and that seemed to relieve Delinar.
Have to keep on a good face. Have to look strong. Don't let him know. Sir, I'm not sure I'll be able to take a post-training of the Radiance. Being with the Windrunners, sending them off to die without me, well, sir, it would rip me apart. I don't think I could see them fly and not join them.
I hadn't considered that. If you'd rather request another duty, I will allow it. Perhaps in logistics or battle planning, or maybe as an ambassador to Thelena or Azir. Your reputation would put you in high esteem there. At any rate, I won't have someone like you sitting around growing creme. You're too valuable.
Sure. Of course. Take from me the one thing that matters, then tell me I'm valuable. We both know I'm nothing.
Kaladin fought against those thoughts and forced out another smile.
I'll think about it, sir. I might need time to decide what I want, though.
Very well, you have 10 days. Before then, I want you to report to me your decision.
He put on another smile, which had the intended effect of convincing Delinar not to worry. The man walked over to the other Windrunners. Kaladin looked away, feeling his stomach twist. His friends were in high spirits. So far as they knew, the Windrunners hadn't lost any members today. They didn't know the truth, that they'd taken a single profound casualty. His name had been Kaladin Stormblessed.